What made the Exponents stand out when they were discovered?
Mike Chun came along and was actually going to see another band called Hip Singles at a venue in Christchurch. We'd kind of been told that he was turning up, but we thought, oh yeah, Mike Chun's coming, how cool, sort of thing, do-do-do. But he loved our enthusiasm on stage. He just thought, wow, I've not seen a band like this. And we're all leaping around and do-do, and the audience were into it. We've been playing for about 6 months, 5 months, and we started off pretty good and we just got better. But I think he liked the enthusiasm, the energy on stage. He'd signed Deadly Smash and he was looking for another band to sign. He signed the Dance Exponents.
Back then, did you do things differently than other bands? And if you did, what were they?
I don't think we were. One thing, it's funny because this question has come up a lot of late. What was different about us starting? I think one of the things is that people that I didn't understand at the time was the fact that essentially five of us had a good 4 years of experience, I call it now, of playing live. And so even though the band, we were together about 8 days before our first gig, but we rehearsed in a bedroom, boom, 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 these are the songs, bam, bam, bam. They all clicked together. It wasn't like a band starting and then going to a pub and they'd only been together a fortnight. We were quite experienced. So when we hit the stage, people were going, oh, wow.
What key things can this generation of fame chasers learn from the Exponents?
Sam, what can you learn from... I don't know, I think... Not a lot. I think it's just important to have really good songs. Sometimes I think being able to work together, or actually not so much work together, working together is kind of important. I think touring together, that's really important.
Before the band took off, did you ever have any doubt of it working out?
I've never had any self-doubt. I didn't think about it taking off or not taking off. I was just concentrating on writing a good song and then performing it well live.
Do you think you're an inspiration to current and later generations of New Zealand artists?
Inspiring other people?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's, I say humbly, that's very proud of that. There are quite a few fish that say, oh, started playing because of you guys, or I love your songs, Jordan, do start writing because of you, I think there's things outside of music that I've done now that have helped people. Something I'm very proud of.
Are we able to still see the Exponents today?
Promotional bit here, Sam. Yes, we're tour Exponents are getting together for the Winery Tour, which is going to be across the nation through February. And we're really looking forward to that. Not only the venues, but I've played a few venues, but I've never done the tour. You put that in three times, you cut it up, put that in three times.
Lastly, what would make the Exponents significant in the music scene and how it still maintains popularity today?
Another one that kind of comes up a lot, since the Hall of Fame thing, I think it's sort of, I think it comes down to the songs. I think Victoria was about 10 years old and I was thinking, it seemed old to me when it was about 5, but then when it was 10, it was just like I'd written it yesterday again, and now it's 30 years old, and I'm thinking, wow, whether I performed it or not, it'd be around. But there's songs like What Is Love, do this to me, and people say, oh, don't know it's me, it's a rugby song, or it's connected to something outside of Exponents altogether. In a tragic way, Christchurch and Castle Street by Wait, which was around, and then it was not around, and then because of the earthquake, it was like, oh, it's that those dance Exponents. And so it's all down to the songs. There's things like, I don't know, I'll be long gone, but I imagine that in the way that Blue Suede Shoes or early rock and roll songs are still known today, these pop songs of today will be around in 50, 60 years. So. I don't know.